January the 10th, 2017, video 2, reflecting on the year since David Bowie died, a year since, I've been up here since, but a year ago I came up here, up to the Iron Age Hill Fort. The sky was blue and pink with big fluffy clouds, with what looked like images of David Bowie lying on his back, floating. I remember, I've got those images still. So today I've come back. Up here is the Iron Age Fort. It was also occupied by the Romans. There's lots of evidence of occupation here and everything like that. There's somebody coming again, so I'm going to have to get out of the way. This bit will be edited and it will go up here, I think. Right, this is the Iron Age Fort up here. What remains of it? The ridges. The defensive walls and boundaries that go across. This is the... This could possibly have been the big main entrance. Further up, there's an area where there's lots of pits where skeletons have been found. They were burial pits and grain pits for storing grain back in those days. So rest in peace, David Bowie. I don't know if that's an appropriate word, so I don't think you'll rest wherever you are. I think you'll be busy. You will be busy. I can't see you resting. Just a little while. You've probably had a rest of a sort while you're finding your feet wherever you are now, Bowie. So, like I said, a year ago there was blue and pink sky with fluffy clouds up here. And I came up here and I was in a type of relaxed shock, I would say, having not really heard much of Bowie over the last, I don't know, few years anyway. And so, like, you know, a lot of people died last year, but nobody affected me like this. And yet they were probably all a part of my life in a way, all those people that have died. Many, many celebrities, many, many ordinary people as well. Many, many people, but obviously it brought to attention the comedians, the rock stars, the film stars that followed David Bowie's death. Somebody else coming. I keep guessing the trouble up here. God, that actually looked like David Bowie walking along over there. When he was younger, bloke walking along, just reminds me of him. Is it David Bowie walking towards me? God, wouldn't that be a shock if that was him? I know it ain't. Oh. Just imagine the activity up here in the past. You would have had all the Iron Age people up here, the Romans. Oh, not very. It's a bit slippery on this bit, actually. A little bit slippery. But this is the Iron Age fort, everyone. And for a moment, I thought I saw David Bowie walking through the wood there. I haven't got my glasses on, by the way. It's sort of tricky play, isn't it? Bless him. I feel like I'm on... I've just arrived on Earth, walking through this wobbly bit. Like the man who fell to Earth. Yes, that person over there walking for a moment. I mean, if you'd had a cap on, God, he would have looked like him even more. I had to divert for a moment. You have to be careful when you're out alone. So now going down, this area changes throughout the year with different seasons. It looks very bleak this time of year, especially with a grey sky. It looks very bleak. I always speak to the trees though. There's a few evergreens here, and of course David Bowie loved his evergreens of England. But I always find this a very peaceful place for me to come. There's a pit there. One of the open pits. There are many, many pits here. The local museum's got lots of information. Hi, trees. That's one of my favourite ones. That tree there, like, is asleep. But it, when the spring comes, you'll see a transformation in that tree. Absolute transformation in these trees when they get their leaves. And we're coming up to an open space in a minute. Oh, here we've got another person coming. It's a jogger this time. And, oh, two of them. It's always a problem. I can't use the... Yes, I can use Zoom on video, actually. I can use Zoom on video, can't I? So I won't get you on the video. I'll point up to the sky. So, hello! Hello, doggy! Hiya! I remember I used to run London Marathons years ago. You wouldn't believe it now, would you? God. So here we come, folks, out into the open space. What a change from last year. This is not looking good. This is very bleak. This is very, very bleak, and I'm worried about it. I mean, David Bowie was always keen on 1984, as I did. I studied it for A-level in English literature. I studied 1984 in detail. I've always loved that book by Orwell. And this bleakness is somehow... I don't know, it's symbolic somehow. I know we can read lots of things into things and all that, but I'm just talking from me, from a personal feeling. This bleakness this year. I think last year with the pink and the blue and even the hints of yellow in the sky and the big clouds made it a gentler way to when he just went. But a year on, is this the future for us? This bleakness is not looking very good, as he said himself, for the 21st century. It's a disappointment, he said. And it is. Look at Syria. Look at all the Yemen. Everywhere there's such hatred and war and It's quite a scary place. People being bombed all the time. Who are going out, having a quiet time. Like the German bombings in the market. I don't want to go on about this too much, but the thing is, this is what is happening in our world. And, it's scary, really. I'm 65 soon. My birthday's in January. My daughter's birthday, Georgia, was on David Bowie's birthday as well. She shares it with him and Elvis. She was 35 the other day. And I'm going to be 65 at the end of January. I love this area, you know. I often walk over there, Sand Bay, and round the other, you know, and all the way along to the Priory that I go to a lot. It's another quiet place I like to go for peace. Lots of history, lots of geology over there. Lots of volcanic rock. This was an area of volcanic activity, one of the few places in the UK where you had this volcanic activity out there somewhere. And it created these humps and bumps leading up to Glastonbury. I do love this. I'm thinking of David Bowie now as I watch the sea. Hear the gentle wind. Trying to hear him in the wind. That tree has seen me up here a few times. This is where I come. I come here. Right then, everyone. No stars out. I've been up here at night, by the way. I've been up here at night on my own. You get a good view of the sky from here, actually. That's why. You get a good view from up here. Over and out.